And in the corner office, a business gone to the dogs. How training Fido is making some rich. Arise XChange starts now. In tonight's corner office, man and dog. Americans spend $58 billion a year on their pets, according to the American Pet Association. And today is, get this, National Take Your Dog to Work Day. Joining us now is dog trainer Marc Elias, owner of Pooch Pals, who also calls himself a canine executive officer. He is here with us because his dog, Riley, he brought Riley to work with him
today.
Hey,
Riley girl. Hey, Andrew. Good to see you.
Good to see you. How did National Dog Day, Take Your Dog to Work Day, come into being? Was it a bunch of people who didn't have kids and therefore couldn't take their kids to work?
The Pet Sitter International Group, they created this opportunity to embrace people that work in offices that want to, you know, hang with their furry kids.
And now, I take it it's a little bit better because are you seeing that that our animal companions, if you will, are better trained and better behaved?
Most of the time they are, Andrew. And I get called in generally after the fact when there's an issue.
When they've gone off the reservation.
Yeah, when they've gone off the reservation, then they call me.
Okay, so to that extent, you buy a puppy. Mm-hmm. When should you start the training process?
It's a really, really great question. So generally, when you have a puppy, you want to actually start the socialization and training process as early as 6 to 7 weeks. Often, vets might recommend that that is maybe a little bit too early, but on the training side with behavior and psychology, we want these dogs socialized and trained as early as possible.
Are these smarter dogs easier to train, or because they're smart, they're saying, you know, the heck with you, I'm just going to do what I want? Or are the dumber dogs harder to train because they're dumb?
That's...
And you know, I hate to say that dogs, some dogs are dumb.
Well, no,
I've had a bunch of them.
Yeah, I know you told me that earlier, you had a bunch of dogs. So dogs are either motivated or they're unmotivated. It's really about finding out what is it that really motivates your dog. And so for the dogs that aren't motivated, we have strategies to kick them into overdrive.
Are you surprised over the years, you've been doing this for quite a few years now, about how much Americans are spending on their animals? I mean, there's a phrase here in New York that dogs are the new kids, which is a somewhat terrible thing to say, but it's really true.
Absolutely. You know, the pet care community, it's just people spend so much money on their dogs. They're bound to spend money on their pets before they are their own
selves. On their children.
Yeah, it's both. They're going to spend money on their pets and their kids before they spend it on themselves. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know that from having a dog. It's just like one of those impulse things. You want to take care of your furry child, and that's where we come in to provide pet care and dog training.
How did you start in the business, and what kind of competition are you facing these days? Because this has got to be a competitive industry.
It is. And, you know, I started in the field roughly about 5 years ago. I was in corporate America making great money, and I wasn't happy.
What were you doing in corporate America?
I was in marketing and
this has got to be a lot more fun.
Oh, are you kidding me?
Let's get Riley up. Does Riley do things?
Riley girl. Come on, baby girl. You want to play with me? So when I started in the pet care field, what I realized
By the way,
was,
I don't know if you can see Riley's bow tie.
Oh, her bow tie.
But Riley is well-dressed.
Yes, of
Riley
course. We're matching, Andrew. We're matching. So having been in the field...
You talk to each other in the morning before you dress.
Oh, of course. Absolutely. Absolutely. It is a competitive field, and you know what makes Pooch Pals unique is that all of our services include positive reinforcement training. So that's dog walking, overnight pet sitting, and boarding.
Yeah, do you believe in positive reinforcement or tough love with the animals?
I love that question. So, Andrew, there's no right way to train your dog, period. And that's how I get people's listening is we train our dogs through just one way, and that's positive reinforcement, shaping behavior through either adding a positive value or removing it. And I've never met a case that I haven't been able to successfully train.
How do you, therefore, maintain the ongoing training with an animal? Is this something like, you know, going to the gym that people need to be bringing their animal back to you all the time?
It is. It's got to be consistent. And, you know, one of the things that our clients do is they'll hire us for private training and then hire us for Monday through Friday dog walking, where our staff will then reinforce the concepts which we've taught them.
It's interesting you say dog walking. We're running out of time.
Yeah.
They really are social animals, and they shouldn't be left alone during the day if not possible.
That's
get
right.
them a friend, a cat, or some other dog,
totally.
Or put him with a dog trainer.
Absolutely. They need play dates. They need socialization. It's good for their head. Good for their body.
It's amazing how doggy spas have sort of sprung up as well.
Oh, it's unbelievable how in the pet care field, more and more premium services are cropping up, from spas to foods to various services. We continue to actually be that in the pet care space.
Marc Elias, summer starts this weekend. Take your pooch out for a walk. I'm Andrew Schmertz. Thanks for watching Arise XChange. Have a nice weekend.